get on the Chris Mingle later.
All right, KR Sports here with Jason Quigley, man. The ESPN.
Give me that strap.
Yeah, let's get that. Let's get that in the shot there. Yeah, man. Hard fought victory over Glenn Tapia, man. Tell me how the fight went.
You know, I was feeling very comfortable in the first, second, third round. You know, I felt as if I was landing my shots clean. I was hurting him. I was rocking him with every decent shot that I landed. I was wobbling him. And I think it was the end of the second round. I cracked him with a left hook, and he danced his way into the corner, you know. But as you can see, you know, I hurt my hand in the second round. That was pretty sore. So I wasn't really able to throw that shot after that. So he's probably seen a change in the fight where I was boxing a little bit more. I was sticking the jab, I was moving. And that's what I had to do, you know what I mean? But there's not every fighter can do that. You know, I hurt my hand and I was able to change up my game plan. Like I said before the fight, my and my team were going in there with more than just A and B game plans. We were going A, B, C, D, E, F, G, the whole alphabet. We were prepared for anything. And, you know, I was very happy with my performance. You know, I stayed relaxed and stayed controlled under everything, you know, with the sore hand and, you know, the way the fight changed a little bit. But this is boxing, you know what I mean? And this is... If I hadn't hurt my hand, I think I would have stopped him. You know what I mean? I was feeling in control. I was landing my shots at will. I was feeling strong. I was feeling comfortable. And, you know, I got in there and it was a great fight. You know, it was a great graduation fight for me. You know what I mean? I was happy I went the 10 rounds, you know, and as they say, if I hadn't hurt the hand, it would have been an earlier night.
Was it a right hand? Where'd you land him or something?
It was a straight right hand just down the pipe. You know, a straight right hand just right down the middle, and I felt it right away. And I threw it two or three times after that, and every time I threw it, you know, the pain was getting worse. You know, so I just had to ease off and just stick and move, the one-handed bandit.
Exactly. I was going to say, I was impressed, Ro, when people were asking me, you know, because I've seen you in camp and I've seen you sparring and things like that. And I was telling them, you know, it looked different to me, and I was telling him, I'm like, you know what, I've seen him spar harder almost, you know what I mean? Because the first two rounds, like you said, you were tagging him, I feel like it was like you in sparring, like you kind of learning stuff, you taking your time. I was like, maybe he wants the rounds, and then it wasn't till the last round that I saw that you weren't using the right hand at all, and I was like, oh, something's wrong. Yeah. Was it good kind of getting that full 10-round experience?
Of course, you know, every fighter wants a knockout. Every fighter wants the early night, you know what I mean? But at the end of the day, I was delighted and happy to go to 10 rounds. If I could have knocked him out in the second or third round, of course I would have done it. You know what I mean? He's a tough lad. You know, he took some heavy shots. And, you know, it was a great fight. It was a great learning fight for me. And, you know, I'm happy with the performance. There's a lot of stuff to work on. And we're going to go back and work on that.
Speaking about taking a good shot, you said he took your shots, but he was getting wobbly. We saw today that Glenn Tapia can hit. He's known as a puncher. And you were getting, he landed a few shots on you, man. You see the eye?
Yeah, of course. You know, this is boxing, this isn't dancing that we're doing. You know, this is what this sport's all about, and this is why I love this sport. You know what I mean? You get out of there, I earned this belt tonight. This is my baby now. This is my little bambino. I'm taking this back to the hills of Donegal, and I'm going to be one proud man doing that, because, you know, this is a tough sport. This has been a tough training camp for me. You know, I got through it. I got through the fight. And I have what counts right here around my shoulder now, you know, and it was a great night for me. It was a great learner for me, you know, injuring my hand in the second round. This is what boxing's all about, you know, and it shows a great champion to come through that kind of stuff.
I feel like this went even better than had you gotten the third, fourth round KO, because you learned that you could deal with adversity. You learned you could fight with one hand. You learned, and fans learned that you could take a shot, obviously. You know what I mean? You got hit a couple times. I'm sure you knew that already, but, you know, maybe just that little twinge of doubt, like what's it like with the smaller gloves. But you got hit. You were fine. I didn't see you dazed at all. I mean, I feel like this is even better than it could have been had you did get the second, third round knockout.
Yeah, of course. You know, as I says, every fighter is lying if they say they don't want to get the knockout. Of course I wanted to get the knockout, but sometimes it doesn't come. You know, it would have came tonight if I hadn't hurt my hand, but I did hurt my hand, and I had to go the distance. But that 10 rounds tonight, that's going to stand by me in the future. You know, I'm going to know how to deal with it, I already went 10 rounds once before, and now I went 10 rounds again.
Yeah.
You know, and these are the type of fights that I need to accelerate into my career, you know, to graduate and to keep learning and keep gaining experience.
I asked Oscar tonight, how soon till you fight like a Lemieux type fighter, someone on that level? And he said that he wants you guys to take your time. You know, he understands you guys are young and you're hungry and you want to kind of, you know, the fast track to the title. But he said maybe like, you know, once you're at 20 fights or so like that, is that kind of you guys still on the same game plan?
Yes, of course, without a doubt. You know, tonight showed, you know, that I have the experience to go the distance. You know, I have the experience to deal with controversy. You know, to deal with stuff that happens, like injuring your hand throughout a fight. You know, I stayed relaxed, I stayed calm, and, you know, I did what I had to do. You know I have a great team behind me. They know they have a great fighter on their hands. You know, it's all about graduating, learning, gaining that experience, and that's exactly what I did tonight.
Well, it was an excellent performance, especially even more so based on the hand injury and everything like that. I'm definitely happy that you got it and you learned as much as you did. And Jason, thank you so much for the time, man. I always appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
Look forward to seeing you again, bro.